projectile motion. Okay, now we have to find out the equation of the path of the projectile. Now this is a one projectile path. We have assumed this one is the path because from our experience, if you throw a stone, it will come back to the ground. So that is, we have assumed this is the path. Now you see at time, this is a xy coordinate. Of course, projectile motion is two dimensional. Now this is at this point, t is equal to 0, and x is equal to 0, and y is equal to 0. Okay. Now here is a horizontal velocity. This is the projectile is thrown at velocity v0 and at an angle theta with the x-axis. This is the x-axis. Okay. So this component is v0 cos theta, and this is v0 sin theta. So vertical component is v0 sin theta, and horizontal component is v0 cos theta. Okay, that you know. And we will be using these formulas already been known to you. V is equal to u plus minus ft. F is the acceleration or deceleration. If you take minus, it will be deceleration, retardation actually. S is equal to ut plus minus half ft square. V square is equal to u square plus minus half twice fs. And sth is equal to u plus half, plus minus half f into twice t minus 1. These formulas we will be using from time to time. Now we have to find out the path of the projectile. So okay, now you understand. We have taken, this is at time t is equal to 0, at time t, now the projectile passes through point P whose coordinate is x and y. That means this one is x and this one is y at time t. Okay, now we'll be using the formulas. Okay, Vx means x component of the velocity at time t is equal to 0 is v0 cos theta, and Vy component of the velocity at time t is equal to 0 is equal to v0 sin theta, that I have shown you. So what is this formula is equal to? S is equal to vt. Now why I will be taking this one? S is equal to ut plus minus half ft square, but in the horizontal there is no acceleration. Acceleration due to gravity is in the downward vertical direction. Okay, so f is equal to 0, so s is equal to ut. Now s, this is the s, x is the s, horizontal velocity is equal to u is this one into t. Okay, so vx 0 is equal to t is equal to x, so t will be equal to x by v0 0 is equal to x by v0 cos theta. This is the equation number 1. So we have found out t. Now what is the distance? This vertical distance will be equal to s is equal to ut plus minus half ft square. So s is equal to u, this is the vertical component of the velocity at time t is equal to 0. So vt at time t, it will be vyt in minus half gt square. Now g is the acceleration due to gravity. It is in this direction. So this is minus g. In the y direction, it is minus g. Okay. So this is the equation. Y is equal to Vy 0 t minus half g t square. So from here you can find out b is equal to vy, no, v0 sin theta. Vy 0 is v0 sin theta t minus half g t square. Now put the value of t here. So if you put the value of t here, x by v0 cos theta, so it is half into x by v0 cos theta whole square. So So it will be this one. So y is equal to x tan theta, because sin theta by cos theta is tan theta, v not cancels out, x is there, x tan theta. So y is equal to x tan theta minus g x square by 2 v naught square cos square theta from here. Okay, so this is the equation, and this equation is a parabolic equation. You know from your school level, because this is y and x, here x is x square, so it is a parabola, and you can find its focus and all other directrices. You can easily find out the apex, whatever it may be. So you, I am not going to details of it, you know it from the coordinate geometry. So this is the equation, and this is the path of the parabola. Okay.